Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the movie Little Women. In fact, we are here at Orchard House. This is the house where Louisa and her family, Louisa May Alcott, by the way, lived for many years. That room right there is where she penned this 1868 book, which has been retold several times, but Greta Gerwig said, you know what? There's room for another. And boy, am I glad she felt that way, because you are in for a treat. It's an all-star cast. I can't even imagine a different cast. And we came here to Concord, Massachusetts, fresh off a little snowstorm. It is picture perfect. And it really helps when the movie is perfect.
I'm working on a novel.
It is a story of my life and my sister's.
So they had done seven, but you thought, you know what, there's room for another one. What number would you have been like, yeah, no more room for another one?
Oh, God. I mean, I feel like, you know, to me, Little Women is one of the great works of literature, and it's part of an American tradition of literature. I think when something's great, you find a new thing in it every time. There's no too many Hamlets. Hamlet continues to tell us who we are.
Frankly, I don't see why she didn't marry the neighbor.
Well, because the neighbor marries her sister.
It was fortuitous. I had read the book again when I was 30, and I saw all these things in it that I felt like I'd never seen before, and I had the idea of wanting to make the film, then I heard they were interested. I forced myself into that room, and I told them I had to write it, and I had to direct it, and they were like, who are you?
I'm so glad it worked out in our favor.
For us before? No, okay, yes, yeah.
They were like, are you funny? Or what? I don't know. Who are you?
Is it fairies? Santa Claus.
The thing that I keep saying to people is that if you're going to do Little Women again, you've got to do something different with it. You can't just sort of do the same thing. And I think, like, cinematically, it's a very effective, powerful thing. She has these, like, connections between one moment that existed in the past and one moment that's existing in the present. And it's like she's acknowledging us. She's going, like, you know what's going to happen, and I'm piecing it together for you. Yeah. And I just think, you know, audiences are sort of smarter than we give them credit for, and she's allowing them to sort of think for themselves and, like, piece it together.
Make it short and spicy. And if the main character is a girl, make sure she's married by the end.
I love how it starts out, and obviously she goes in and the publisher says, make it short and spicy.
Yeah.
So if you could pick two adjectives to describe this film that you're a part of, what are the two?
Whole truth.
Oh, those are good.
I did not expect that. Okay. I was like, where's this prank going?
No.
I wish you were here at the start of the day.
Vibrant. Epic.
Epic. Revolutionary. Yes.
Perfect.
Oh, God. Yeah,
complicated.
Come on,
say emotional. Well, she's after taking two more words. I would say lively and thoughtful.
You'd stink at Family Feud, by the way. I'm very happy with that.
I did do Family Feud on Jimmy Fallon once, and I was terrible at it. And
you'd be like, one qualification, one point.
Steve Harvey just shook his head at me the whole time.
He really? Was like, oh, you what? Really did it?
Yeah.
That's on YouTube?
Like, it was terrible. Anyway, I have too many adjectives. I'm a maximalist. I mean, I'm spiky, cozy, epic, revolutionary, intimate, strange, beautiful.
Joe, would you like to dance with me?
I'm a fan of the tradition of movies, and one thing in movies is a great cinematic pairing, whether it's Lauren Bacall and Humphrey Bogart, or Jenna Rollins and John Cassavetes, or Fred and Ginger, or
Brad and Angelina.
these again and again. There's something like that felt traditional about that to me. Like, let's put these two great actors together again.
I scorched my dress, see? There. And Meg told me to keep still so no one would see it.
What I think Greta has especially brought to this version is this theme of artistic empowerment. With Joe's role as an artist, could be substituted for anything. That could be a scientist, could be anything. This happens to be art in this movie.
And I'm so sick of people saying that love is just all a woman is fit for. I'm so sick of it.
I love the fact that it starts with you're taking a breath, you're walking in there, and clearly there's that big transition between when you first go see this publisher and at the end when you kind of own it and you're like, actually, that's not gonna, it's not gonna be good enough for me in the negotiation. I want just each of you, when was that moment for you when you went from being nervous, you gotta pitch yourself, and then all of a sudden, actually, you know what? Here's what I'll take in that negotiation, when you kind of owned your power.
If we're talking about art, I feel like we share that committed voice always. Mm. When you're talking about money and negotiating and believing in your worth, I'm just learning about that now.
Mm. Really?
Oh, yeah. And no one ever talked to me about money or negotiating or a right to something at all.
And as a woman, there's no way for me to make my own money.
The first person that I actually heard from someone to say, you do realize you can stand up to that and you are bigger than you think you are, was last summer, Jack Rayner, during Midsummer. I was having issues just with stuff. And it was the first time that I'd actually, from a man, he was like, you can call the shots. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh, I can. Mm-hmm. But it did take 22 years.
It's hard, yeah. I mean, it's still something that I really have to practice, because I can very easily slip back into that thing of like, I don't want to upset anyone, I don't want to bother anyone. And I know, I think the same for me, whenever it's come to like a job I've wanted to do or the work itself, I've always had this strength, because it's like having a child or something, like you just get this superhuman strength where you're like, well, no, I have to protect the work that I'm doing. Mm. And there was something that I was being asked to do, like a press commitment thing for another film while I was doing this new movie that I was on, and it was going to mean that I was, you know, this big scene that I was going to have to do was going to be put in jeopardy, and I just wouldn't do it. And the very powerful people that I had to say no to, who didn't like it at all, it was scary, and I hated it, and I hated like letting people down. Mm. And also just like, from a selfish point of view, you're like, I still want people to like me, you know.
It's a very actor thing too.
It's a very actor thing. You want acceptance and all that. But when I did it and I was like, oh, I can do this, and I got respect for it, it was amazing. I had this like wind behind my sails then.
Was there a moment where you made that shift?
No, because that's when you're done, right? Like, no, I don't know. How do you feel about that?
I've pretended to be that person. Okay. Sometimes I go into, I think for this film, I went into these offices and I said, well, I'm going to write it and I'm going to direct it and here's what it's going to be. And then I'd leave and I'd be like, oh my God.
Yeah, did you say that?
I just say that out loud. So I feel like I've pretended to be the person who's like, take it or leave it. But, you know, it's like Sondheim says, like, everything you do, you still audition.
The world will forget that you ever even lived.
I'm sure they will.
No one will forget Joe March.
On Lady Bird, I was terrified. And I think it was, I loved it, but it was really wonderful to have done her first film with her. And then I think for the two of us to come back together with everyone else, and like for all of us to come to this material for the first time. Mm-hmm. And we've all kind of got our own experiences with Louise's book, and I don't know, it just felt like everyone was able to bring a piece of themselves to it.
It is in a rhythm, it's not in a random.
I know Greta says you're gonna direct. If she wants to be in the movie, are you gonna make it hard for her?
Yeah, exactly.
Make her sweat it out a little bit?
She's gonna audition, ask me at least twice. Yeah, she's gotta audition first.
I want to be great or nothing.
I hope that they feel what I feel, which is, you know, you wanna crawl inside the movie and live with these people, because to me, that's such a feature of movie going, particularly, you know, at Christmas time, that feeling of wanting to be inside that world with those people. It's both the warmth and the heart and the coziness of this movie, and that makes it so delicious, and people hang on to it for 150 years, but also that it gives them that spark of inspiration, that spark of, now you go do it, now you go write your song, or your book, or make your quilt, or tell your story, in some way, giving it back to the audience. And I hope that's what they walk out of the theater with. I hope they're moved to create.
There are some natures too lofty to bend.
Okay, I don't care if you're a little woman, a little boy, a little man, a grown woman, a grown man, you will really love this movie. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, giveaways. In the meantime, I think I've got a book to reread. Greta says she reread it and saw things she never saw when she was a kid. I think it's my turn.